Have you ever started a business or opened a new market? If so, you may have faced the scenario that I faced when I started my first business. I was in the second year of selling decorative tins to food packers, and my business was failing. I was losing money. And then I discovered the one single account that would turn my business around, Bunty Candy. They bought 1 million of the type of decorative tin that I sold. So I called on Bunty Candy with a special offering, but unfortunately, the buyer said, "I'm good. We've been buying from General Can for 5 years and we're happy." So I left dejectedly. The year continued to get worse and worse, and in the summer, my car failed. And at a critical moment, when I was in emotional freefall, when I felt like George Bailey at the bridge in It's a Wonderful Life, I asked myself this critical question: who's the real decision maker here? It's not Bunty Candy, it's their customer, the retailer. And so with my last marketing money, I put together an offering of special art, and I reached out to 400 retailers, to the food buyers. And I was lucky, because although Bunty Candy had no interest in my special offer, there was one retailer who did care: Walmart. And that retailer instructed Bunty for them to bring me with them to Bentonville. And my business turned around and took off from that point. There are two takeaways from this story. The first one is bold vision, bold behavior. The bold vision was the special artwork offering. The bold behavior was going around Bunty to the ultimate decision maker, Walmart. The second takeaway was the do or die attitude. I had to have a do or die attitude to survive that scenario. And since that time, many years ago, I have maintained the do or die attitude in my mind. I always see myself at the edge of a cliff being pushed off by a bear, and I have to fight back from that position. And by seeing myself in that position, I prevent myself from being in an actual do or die scenario. And that's my gift to you.